Hello guys, lesson 3, Programming Logic Control, PLC. Introduction to PLC. A gate is a device that performs a basic operation on electrical signals. Gates are combined into circuits to perform more complicated tasks. Let's examine the processing of the following 6 types of gates. So we have NOT, AND gate, OR gate, XOR gate, NAND gate, NOR gate. Typically, logic diagrams are black and white, and the gates are distinguished only by their shape. We have 6 different types of gates. The first one is the AND, and this is the shape of the AND, OR, NOT, NAND, we can see, and here we have NOR and XOR. Okay, now I'm going to explain these 6 gates in details. The first gate is the NOT gate. A NOT gate accepts one input value and produces one output value. Let's see this this NOT gate. We have this triangle and a bubble here. The input is capital A. I suppose the input is capital A and the output capital X. Now, if the input is logic 0, the output will be logic 1. And if the input A, logic 1, the output logic 0. So we inverse the situation, okay, from 0 to 1 and from 1 to 0. This is the Boolean expression. X, the output, it's equal to A, but we put this notation. This means X equal A inverse, okay? So X is the inverse of A. Of course, maybe someone asked me what's the meaning of logic 0 and logic 1. Logic 0 maybe in some systems mean there is no voltage, 0 voltage, and logic 1 means 5 voltage, or maybe means 3 voltage. When I have at the input 0 volt, I'll get at the output 5 volt. 1 means 5 volt, and when I have logic 1 at the input, this means 5 volts at the input, I'll get 0 volt at the output. Okay, I'll move for the next gate, the NOT gate. By definition, if the input value for a NOT gate is 0, the output value is 1, and if the input value is 1, the output is 0. You can read this explanation, it's very clear, but sometimes we call the NOT gate like an inverter. Okay, here we have NAND gate. A NAND gate accepts 2 input signals. So, let's see the shape of the NAND gate. This is the shape of the NAND gate. It contains 2 inputs, A and B, and 1 output. Let's see the Boolean expression. X equal A and B. In AND gates, if any of the inputs is 0, the output X will be 0. For example, when I have 0, 0 at the input, the output, of course, it will be 0. But when I have 0, 1, so the input A is 0, the output also will be 0. When I have input A equal to 0, the output 0. When B equal to 0, X equal to 0. But when I have both of the inputs equal to 1, logic 1, the output will be logic 1. To understand AND gate more clearly, I suppose I have 2 electrical switches and we connected them on series. Then these 2 switches are connected to a battery and to a bulb. This circuit is open at switch A and switch B, so the bulb will not turn on. Okay, it's off. Now, if I suppose this switch A is open, this means logic 0, and B is open, logic 0, and the bulb also will be 0, okay? So when I have 0, 0, the output will be 0. I'll take another example. I suppose I have 0, 1. This means switch A is on, sorry, switch A is off. and switch B is on. So switch A is logic 0 and switch B is logic 1. So in this case, switch B will be closed. So let's see the output or the bulb. Of course, the bulb will not turn on. Why? Because switch A is open, so there is no current flow through this circuit. Let's take the last case when I have 1 1, the output 1. This means switch A is a close and switch B is a close too, and in this case I have a closed circuit, so the current can flow from the positive terminal to the negative terminal of the battery, and then the bulb will turn on. Okay, so here I have the output logic 1 OR gate. If the two input values are both 0, the output value is 0, otherwise the output is 1. Okay, let's see. This is the shape of the OR gate. This is the logic diagram symbol of the OR gate. We have two inputs A and B and one output X, and this is the Boolean expression of the OR gate. The output X equal A or B. Now let's see the truth table. The first case 0 0, and the output is 0. When we have 0 1, the output 1, and 1 0, the output 1, 1 or 1, the output is 1. To understand OR gate more clearly, I suppose I have two switches on parallel, and these two switches are connected through battery and a bulb. Okay, I'll call this one switch A and switch B. Now let's examine the truth table. The first case, when I have 0 0, this means both of the switches A and B are open, so I have 0 and 0. Of course, there is no current flow through this circuit because the circuit is open, so the output will be 0. The next case, when I have 0 1, this means switch B is on, so I close. When I have 0 1, this means switch B is a close, so I have an close switch here. So I have logic 1 and 0. Now let's see, the current will flow from the positive terminal through the bulb and through switch B to the negative terminal of the battery. So in this case, the bulb will turn on. Okay, so I have logic 1. Now I'm going to examine the third case. 1 0, A or switch A is a close and switch B is open. So this is switch A and B. Switch A is a close, so the current also flow through the circuit from the positive terminal through switch A to the negative terminal, and the bulb will turn on. Okay, so I have logic 1 here, also logic 1. And when both of the switches are closed, of course the current will pass through switch A and B, and the output will be logic 1 2. The next case is the XOR or exclusive OR. We call this gate XOR gate or exclusive OR gate. An XOR gate produces 0 if its two inputs are the same and 1 otherwise. So you can read this explanation. Let's see the logic diagram. Here I have the logic diagram of this circuit, the logic diagram of the XOR circuit, and I have two inputs A and B and the output X. Now let's see the truth table. When I have 0 0, the output will be 0, and when I have 1 1, we can the two inputs are the same, so the output is 0 2. So OR gates, when the two inputs are the same, the output is 0. In the case of 0 0, the output is 0. In the case of 1 1, the output is 1. But when we have a difference between the two inputs 0 1, the output equal to 1 or logic 1, and when we have the input 1, 0, the output equal to 1. Okay, let's see the Boolean expression. X equal A XOR B. This is the notation of the Boolean expression. It's a plus inside a circle. And finally, we have NAND gate. The NAND gate is essentially the opposite of the AND gate. Here we have the logic diagram. Is the same as the AND gate except this bubble. This bubble mean inverter. So let's see the Boolean expression. X equal A and B bar. Okay. This bar reverse the output. So if the output is 1, then it will be 0 because we have this bar. Or if A and B equal to 0, the output will be 1 because of this bar. Okay, so we can examine the truth table. 0, 0, it's 1. 0, 1, it's 1. 1, 0, it's 1. And 1, 1, it's 0. Remember, the AND gate, the AND output was 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, so we can see the NAND is the opposite of the AND gate. Finally, we have the NOR gate. The NOR gate is essentially the opposite of the OR gate. Let's examine the Boolean expression. X equal A plus B bar. Okay, this bar comes from the bubble here. Okay. This means when we find the output, we need to inverse it. Okay, so this means when we find the output, we need to reverse it. So if the output logic is 0, then we will write logic 1. And if the output is logic 1, we will write it logic 0 because of this bar or this inverter. Okay, so let's examine the truth table. When we have 0, 0, the output is 1. 0, 1, the output is 0. 1, 0, the output is 0. And 1, 1, the output is 0. Now let's compare the output of the NOR gate with the output of the OR gate. Okay, remember the output of the OR gate was 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay, so let's see, it's the opposite. When we have logic 1 in the NOR gate, the OR gate was 0. The 0 in the OR gate, when we have 0 in NOR gate, we have 1 in OR gate, and so on. Okay, so OR gate is the opposite of the NOR gate. Thank you for listening. If you like my videos, please subscribe my channel.